Welcome back to Sounds for Streets and More. We're doing a quiz tonight, and it is, forgive me, geography, what quiz are we doing, even though it tells me in the title? And I'm not prepared, I need to get the questions up, and let me share this out, whilst we wait for some people to come in. Hilda DC and Patrick are waiting to get into the house, but I've now given them access. So, yes. Hey, Explorer McGar, thanks very much for coming in. Hey, Unicorn Girl 2020, thanks very much for all coming in. Let me get the questions up. So, forgive me, guys, 1 second. I've got so many bloody windows open, so let me just close those windows for a brief second. And my new ring light, by the way, guys, arrives tomorrow. Because you guys saw my previous live stream, I broke my ring light. So I've got a new one for £10 later, coming tomorrow from Amazon. Hey, Duke Newtown Abyss 28, Jamie. Hey, Rick, thanks very much for all creating it. And I'm also in here tonight because I wanted some action. I wanted some weather action. The weather's been beefy. I was hoping for maybe some thunderstorm action to make a vlog, but it's just been tipping it down with rain because we had like beefy clouds come over, and now the beefy clouds seem to be breaking up again now. Welcome to England, guys, where the weather changes every 5 seconds. Anyway, we're doing a geography quiz, so let me just get the questions up. I was looking for my quiz and it came up with George Asta. Hey, Lego Dude 5000, thanks so much for coming in. You are a new familiar face of the channel, so feel free to subscribe if you haven't already. And make sure you guys, if you're new to the live streams and the quizzes, make sure you guys read the chat rules down below. Hey, February 90, what's that as emoji of? Pork? Oh, beef! I was like, yeah, beefy, yeah, beefy. Yeah, beef like that. Hey, Queen, thanks very much for coming in, Beefy. We want to join in, but I'm cool, but I'll still be listening. You can join if you want to. Anyone can join in. It's probably easier tonight anyway because it's a bit more easier. Oh, okay, I could do to 5,000. Hey, 345 Berry. Forgive me, you've changed your name. 345 Berry. Oh, that's a really long name. I'm not very good with long names, girl. 345 Berry trains, lifts, vlogs, and more. Forgive me, 345 Berry. How come you decided to add about 12 different words to the end of your name, girl? Oh, you're cooking. You said you're cool. I'm like, eh? You can't type. No, you can't type. Neither can I sometimes, Dave, to be honest with you. The amount of times I said when I come onto your lives, I say, what was that I said that time? You were saying something like, when you do your live next time, and I said, I'm with my love tomorrow at 8 p.m. I'm going live tomorrow at 8 p.m. I will it. That's sad. I'm not sure about the ones that are still near me. I think they're still open for a few more weeks, Jamie. Hey, Zach's Fantastic Trains. Thanks very much for coming in. Hello. You're laughing at me now. Let's ask the questions up. We may have actually featured quite a lot of these. Oh, has it gone? Has it the one in Lincoln? There's one in Coventry and there's one in Birmingham. There's one in Manchester still. There's a few like not too far away from where I live, but quite a lot of them are closing down now. The flagship store in England closed down. Oh, the flagship, is that the Oxford Street? Yeah, the Oxford Street one. It was open at Christmas time, but then we had the national lockdown. So that one closed, I believe the last day of it actually was actually the 16th of December. No. I think last day was the 21st of December, I believe, for that one. Because then they had tier 4, didn't they? They said, so they all had to close. I first announced a change, so I did. I hope you like it. It may still call me 345 Bears. I still am. Yeah, 345 Pay, forgive me. The name's really long at the end now, so it might be a little bit harder for people to find you. But if people just search 345 Bear, you'll probably come up. But let's say if people search that name, it might be a little bit hard to find because it's such a long name. That makes sense. So when I'm probably doing the Make New Fans with Channel Exposure Thursday, I'll probably just type your name in as 345 Barry when we feature your channel if you're in there. But make sure you hit thumbs up as well, guys. I see there's 9 in the house and only 6 thumbs up. So make sure you hit thumbs up and share out the stream. Whether you've got Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Reddit, feel free to hit thumbs up and share me out, guys. And then we'll get kick-start with the questions in just a few minutes. I want to wait for some people to come in first, though. And just make sure I finish preparing for the live stream to be... for the quiz to begin, and then hopefully it won't drag on for almost 7 hours like it was. My mum's saying sorry because my sister just dropped something off. Clouds are wet. What do you mean by that, Zach? Hey MSK family vlogs, thanks very much for coming in. Thanks very much for giving me a thumbs up. I really appreciate everyone's love and support you guys give me as always. And yeah, I can unpin that message now. The new ring light that I've ordered, by the way, comes tomorrow. Forgive me for my mum in background. Hey Kevin, thanks very much for coming. So hope everyone is all well tonight. I appreciate everyone's love and support. But anyway, we're going to start with the questions because, as you know, we're doing a geography quiz. So this one's probably going to be easy because quite a lot of these questions are kind of general knowledge as well. But thanks very much for all coming in. You're well, that's good that you're good. Love a good sausage bap. What do you mean when you love a good sausage bap? I do like a sausage bap. I do, guys. I do love a sausage bap. Forgive me, Kevin. You always say word up. Does that mean like hello? Because I've always seen you do that, say word up, and I'm like, eh? I was thinking what on earth does word up mean at first, and then I'm like, it's just basically you saying hello. Thank you for sharing me out on Reddit. I was just mentioning Reddit a minute ago. I was like, if anybody wants to share me out, feel free to share me out on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, community tab. Thanks so much for sharing me out, though. But anyway, should we start with the quiz questions? Now there's 10 in the house, so make sure you hit thumbs up, go, guys. In fact, the numbers are creeping up, so the thumbs up aren't matchy-matchy, so make sure you give me thumbs up, guys. Harvey is basically dead. M&S in Harvey Centre is gone, quite huge too, and many other major tenants are gone. Oh, right, Newtown Abbey is 2-8. That's a shame. But anyway, we're doing a geography quiz, so obviously you guys can answer the questions whether you want, and the first person that I see on my side we'll get the point. I know quite a lot of people say don't put answers in the chat for quizzes, but this is where I want you to put answers in the chat. Because if you haven't already had a shout out on the channel before, I will give you a shout out. Obviously, Fabian United's just had one, so he won't be getting one, which is fair enough. But anyone that does it and you can play for fun too. So yeah, let's get started with the questions then. So in no particular order, we obviously have these questions, and then I do a little random of my own, and then we also have a silly question that is not related to the quiz at all, and then we reveal the results, Britain's Got Talent style, and then we think about a topic for next week's quiz. It's from a song in the 80s. That you know why, Kevin? It's because I'm so young, so I'm like, eh? Use it as a greeting. Anyway, guys, so, yeah, let's get started with the questions. So, question one. In which country would you... I can't speak. In which country would you be if you were visiting the Taj Mahal? In which country would you be if you're visiting the Taj Mahal? And forgive me for the pronunciations, guys. I'm rubbish at pronouncing stuff. But to the chat, Kevin, thanks very much for coming in. Hilda, you see, one of the moderators is in the house. Oh, and forgive me, guys. I haven't even got the notebook out. Forgive me, guys. 1 second. I need the notebook. Where's my bag? I have got the notebook. And I think someone answered it. Yes. Faye Bruni 90 on my end first, got it. Because he answered with... Have we got any spare damn pages in this book? He answered with India. That is correct. I've spilled something on this notebook. This notebook is really starting to run out of pages, so soon we'll be having to... start again. A notebook. Anyway, next question. Which country's name would be part of a Christmas dinner? Which country's name could be part of a Christmas dinner? Which country's name could be part of a Christmas dinner? Which country's name could be part of a Christmas dinner? And I'll give it to the first two people, guys. Oh, I say that and two people have just said it already. Newtown Abyss 208, Jamie and Faye Bruni 90. It is Turkey. Because obviously, Turkey the country, and then Turkey as in... And Brussels, I believe, Brussels could be one, but I think Brussels is actually a city, isn't it? Or is it a country? Hey, Corrine's Crafts, that's the brand new channel for Corrine's Life. So we'll have a look at that new channel of hers when we do the Make New Friends and Channel Exposure on Thursday. But thanks very much for coming up. And Corrine's Crafts, because that's obviously Corrine, I'll just give you Blue Jacket on that channel too. Because obviously you'll be here on both channels and you have to help out with the moderation on both. But anyway, so Faye Bruni 90 and Newtown Abyss 208, Jamie. Actually, I can just bite you in the notes because it's buddy Jamie. I still know who you are. Next question. Yeah, that's brand new. That's Corrine's brand new account. And obviously, if you guys want to grab her up, you can grab each other still. You can grab each other up and make friends with each other if you want to. However, just know I am doing a quiz night tonight, so I'm not showcasing anyone's channels. But you can grab people up, but make sure you feel people out first, because not everyone in there is willing to make friends. But most people are. But next question. Which stretch of water separates the Anglia and Wales? Which stretch of water separates the Isle of Anglia and Wales? Hey, Crispy Z, Cadiz died. I don't know who Cadiz is, unfortunately, but that's a shame. Make sure you don't put full caps in my live chat, though, because that's considered, make sure you read the rules down below, Crispy. Yeah, the Isle of Anglia and Wales. Which river separates those two continents? Continents? Islands? Yes, Zach got it. And Zach, forgive me, you're new to the channel as well. So make sure you guys have subscribed. And make sure you read the chat rules down below as well. And Zach got it. It is the Mandi Strait. Is your name have a K on the end or is it a CH? The Isle of Anglia. You see, I'm crap at pronunciations. Anyway, next question. In which continent is the world's longest river, the Nile? In which continent is the world's longest river, the Nile? Avon. Avon's a river, yeah. Not the makeup. It can't be a makeup too. Africa. Yep, Jamie got it. It is Africa. Right, next question. We're moving quite fast tonight. What colour is the spot in the middle of the Japanese flag? What colour is the spot in the middle of the Japanese flag? And I'll give the first two people that get it right. Newtown Abbeyist and Fable United. It is red. You guys are doing well tonight. And I've had quite a lot of people confess that they're Googling Kareem's crafts, vlogs, trains and more. Kareem told me she Googled the quiz I was doing and it came up with the one. So don't be doing that because that'd be cheating and you'll be disqualified. But Fable United, Jamie got the point for that. Next question. And Kareem's probably going to say, Sam, don't give away my secrets. Is Australia in the northern or southern hemisphere? And the first three people that get it right. Is Australia in the northern or southern hemisphere? The first three people that get the answer right will get the point. Newtown Abbey is 2-8, Jamie. Another two people need to say southern hemisphere. And hit thumbs up as well, guys. Only one more thumbs up to get to 10 and share me out, guys. I know a few people have already shared me out, which I really appreciate that. Yeah, Fable and Unity and 345 Barry. It is the southern hemisphere. Right, next question. We won't do that question because that's really long. In which English county might you find the towns Darwin and Nelson? In which English county might you find the towns Darwin and Nelson? And only one person. Fable and United is on the ball because he's from England, so that one's quite easy for people that live in the UK. Yeah, it is Lancashire. Right, now, I'm actually going to, again, give the first three people that get this answer right. Which is taller, the Eiffel Tower or the Blackpool Tower? Which is taller, the Eiffel Tower or the Blackpool Tower? Three, four, five, base from Essex, I'm in Yorkshire. Yep. Jamie, Eiffel 65. Yeah, I'm 345, Barry, yep. You guys are all right. It is the Eiffel Tower. Right, next question. I thought I heard thunder then. I'm like, is the action going to start whilst I'm live streaming? Because that would dead annoy me. Baku is the capital city of which Eastern European country? Baku is the capital city of which Eastern European country? And I can't pronounce this answer one bit. So as soon as I see it in the live chat, I'll just say, yep, you've got it right. Because I can't pronounce this answer one bit. Nope, not Romania. Baku is the capital city of which Eastern European country.
I can't wait for my new ring light, because then I'll have more lighting on my face. No, 345 Bay, not that. And not Romania. You guys might have to do some research for this one. Annoying spots. And Finland was great yesterday, by the way. Zach got it. I cannot pronounce that, but he's right. A something. Anyway, right, next question.
What lake holds the largest volume of water in the UK? What lake holds the largest volume of water in the UK?
Hey, Lincolnshire Level Surf Crossings and Strange Channel. Forgive me, when did you arrive? Did I welcome you? Can't remember. Forgive me if I didn't. But you might have to refresh because you're a bit behind.
Which lake holds the largest volume of water in the UK?
Lincolnshire Level Crossings and Strange Channels was just before Faiburn United with Loch Ness, which is in Scotland, I believe. Forgive me, I can't remember on that one. Right, next question.
The M1 motorway in England is how many miles long? And I believe I've had this question in a previous quiz. The M1 motorway in the UK is how many miles long?
Hey, Arlok. Hey, Scratch and Pete. Thanks very much for both of you coming in. Scratch and Pete PA was one of the beloved moderators and one of the most supportive people on the entire of YouTube. And he had a cool premiere earlier. And I got it. I missed it. I was bloody, what was I doing when I came? Oh, I was women having dinner. And I missed it. So forgive me for that, Pete. Next time, I'll have dinner later, Sam. You're on our work today. That's fine. Newtown Abbey is too late. It runs actually just south of Rugby to, just south, north of, just south of the border. No, that's the M6 you're thinking of. The M1 runs from Rugby to Leeds, from London to Leeds. That's the wrong motorway, Newtown Abbey is too late. That's the M6. The M1 runs from London to Leeds.
In miles, how many miles long is the M1 motorway in the UK? In miles, how many miles is the M1 motorway in the UK?
Yeah, that's the M6, Newtown Abbey is too late. Yeah, that's a clue for you. So the M1 runs between London and Leeds in England.
A1's a separate road. It is 345 Bay. A1's actually the longest road in the UK, running from London to Edinburgh in just 4 hours and 27 minutes if you drive fast at night.
Do you guys want a clue? Another clue? I will deduct 1 point off each if you don't, if you ask for a clue. No, I'm not that harsh. That's called Newtown Abbey is too late. That's because you're from Northern Ireland. Hey, Lottie, thanks so much for coming in. You're not that late. You're only 25 minutes late. We've still got a lot of questions to go, so you haven't missed out, don't worry. I could do that in 3 hours. Depends on the traffic conditions, to be honest with you. 251. No, it's a little bit less. It's a little bit less than that, Zach. And thanks very much. I see we've got over 10 thumbs up now, which is nice. Yes, Faiburn United finally got it. It was 193 miles.
Right, next question.
How many national parks are there in the country of Wales? How many national parks are there in the country of Wales? Why are all of these questions in the UK? I don't get that. How many national parks are in the country of Wales? And the first two people that get this will be right. Lottie was very specific there, which is why I'm going to give you a funny point. Lottie, you can have a point there because you're very specific. It is about that, yeah. Newtown Abbey's 2-8 and Fable United with 3. Right, next question is... In which country is the world's highest waterfall? In which country is the world's highest waterfall? Oh, did you just guess, did you, Jamie? Yeah, it's 3. In which country has the highest waterfall? And I've never heard of this damn country, and it's probably another one I can't bloody pronounce. Those clouds do look rather beefy. Iceland? No, not Denmark. Niagara Falls? No. That's fine, MSK fan folks. You have a good one. Thanks, Amish, for coming in, my friend. Nigeria. Zimbabwe? No. Not that one. Lincolnshire, Ever Crossings and Train Channels. Tanzania. Tesco! Why are you naming the UK supermarket?
You can have a funny point for that one.
Oh, what are you naming supermarkets for? Yes! Fable United got it and was very specific. Angel Falls, Bazovia, Venezuela. Why are we all naming UK supermarkets now?
I can't give everyone a 50 point though. But anyway, next question is... What is the oldest recorded town in the UK? What is the old... Fable Nottingham. I was in Nottingham yesterday. Nice little station. Very confusing layout, but nice station Nottingham is. Plenty of traffic. What is the oldest recorded town in the UK?
London? No, London's a city. Town. Emsbury? No. You wouldn't believe this one. Hey, Lincoln Level Crossings NI, thanks so much for coming in. Obviously, if you guys aren't connected with the channel, feel free to click the red button that says subscribe. And make sure you redo all the chat rules if you're new to the live streams. It may look strict, but it's not too bad. Everyone gets used to it. Stratford-upon-Avon? No, I was in Stratford-upon-Avon 2 weeks ago, actually. Or no, just under 2 weeks ago. I was there 1st of May. Grimsby? Nope. Colchester! 345 Berry was in there, and I wasn't expecting it to be Colchester. I was like, yeah, Colchester, really?
But yeah, 345 Berry got it. It is Colchester's. Right, next question. In what country would you find Lake Bled? What country would you find Lake Bled?
What country would you find Lake Bled? You have no idea of any of these questions, do you, Pete? We're doing geography. Was you good at geography in school, Pete? I wasn't actually too bad, you know. Considering I dropped out, lol.
Slovakia? No, be close though.
Oh, forgive me, Level Crossings. Is your name Then. Is your name Jack? Slovenia! Yes, Lottie got it. Hey, Red Hot Reaction Steve, you're until 10. Forgive me, do you have a premiere coming up at 10 p.m, Red Hot Reactions? Lincolnshire Level Crossings. I'm getting bloody sidetracked by someone else's name. Okay, Level Crossings. That's fine. Have you got a premiere coming up at 10 o'clock then? Steve. Because if so, I can raid that for you, because that's in just under an hour's time.
So, Lotte, I need to put your point down. I almost forgot to do that. And we'll move on to your final question. I'm just waiting for the response to your question there, Steve. Anyway, what is the smallest country in the world? What is the smallest country in the world?
And don't say the UK, because it's not that small, if you think about it. Newton Abbas Toure got it. It is the Tisian City. I'm going to message you about something on Insta which isn't appropriate on this live stream. Okay, I'll look. The North Pole.
You guys try to all get funny points. Right, next question. How many US states begin with the letter A? How many US states begin with the letter A? How many states begin with the letter A?
And the first three people will get the answer right. And bonus point if you can name me them. Yep, Newton Abbas 2-8, got it. 4. Scratching Pete,
4.
Fabulini 94. Yep. And Lottie's just behind with 4,
so I'm going to give you all 4 the point. I know I said first. Oh, yeah, I did say first 4, didn't I? Yeah, forgive me.
Yeah, it is. So I've got
Jamie.
I've got
Scratching Pete is
Scratching Pete is 4. Lincolnshire Level Crossings and Train Channel is 4. Oh, and Lottie, I'll give you. You're just behind.
Right, next question. Moving on now. And the next question is, what is the highest mountain in Britain? What is the highest mountain in Britain?
And this one is a nice, easy one. You're still lurking in the background, are you, Hildebats? No worries at all.
So,
What is the
tallest mountain in the UK? In Britain. What is the highest mountain in Britain? What is the highest mountain in Britain?
Three, 4, 5, barely got it. No, Lincolnshire Level Crossings and Train Channel was just first.
It is Ben Nevis.
Snowdonia, no, and Mount what's that tall? What's that? Mount Everest is the tallest mountain in the world, not in the UK. Level Crossings and I, don't be inappropriate in the chat, please.
Right, next question. Da-da-dum. The 2000 movie Amelia is set in which part of Paris? The 2001 film Amelia was set in which part of Paris?
East? No. Pete, as soon as I get my mic for the ASMR, I'll do.
Yeah.
Just 1 second, guys. Just 1 second. Just forgive me, guys. I was just organising a raid. South? West? No. The Eiffel Tower part? Yes!
Mint Marriott. Yes, I think that's how you pronounce it. And Fabled United got it.
It's not Mint. Mont Marriott. But you're the closest, so I'll give you the point.
Right, next question. In which European city would you find the Spanish Steps? In which European city would you find the Spanish Steps?
Answer my question. Oh, sorry, forgive me, HLGC. Where did you put your question? I can't see your question, HLGC.
Oop.
Madrid? Nope. Barcelona? Nope. Malta? Nope. Spain? Yes! Pete got it. Rome, Italy.
Well done, Pete.
Okay, you take care, Jamie, and take care of level crossings. Thanks so much for coming in. Please don't be rude in the chat. Level crossings, NI. I'm going to put you in timeout now. Please don't be rude in the chat. It's very offensive. If I see Bean C one more time, you'll have to block, unfortunately. Next question.
Because Pete got the answer to that one. Right. What is the unit of currency of Poland? What is the unit of currency in Poland? What is the unit of currency in Poland?
Euro? No. Scratching Pete's just in first with Zloty. Hey, Willows Creations. Thanks very much for coming in.
Oh, my blooming pillow's falling off my bed. Pete with Zloty. Right, next question. And then we'll do the question that's not related to the quiz shortly. The Sahara Desert extends to how many countries? Multiple choice for this one. Is it A, 5, B, 10, or C, 13? The Sahara Desert extends to how many countries? Is it A, 5, B, 10, or C, 13? Yes, Lottie's just in there first with 10. And it's not 13, it's 10. Right. Final question for the this quiz that I found online is, which group of travellers set out from the Tarbin Inn? Which group of travellers set out from the Tarbin Inn?
What group of travellers set out from the Hey, Bolton Explorers. I don't think that was aimed at me, Bolton, but yeah, I can't have that inappropriate stuff in the chat, so one more warning and he's going to be blocked. Okay, no worries, Kareen. All of the above.
Premier in 9345, Perry. What group of travellers set out from the Tarbin Inn?
The Cowboys. Station. Quite a hard one, this, so you might have to pimp out Google for this one. And only two more thumbs up to get to 15. So if you haven't already, give me a thumbs up. We appreciate it if you did. That's another word I need to add to the block twist. Willow's Creations is playing around with some YouTube emojis.
Nope. I'll give you a clue. In the Canterbury Tales.
Nice big clue for you guys.
It's the part of the answer is the Canterbury Tales. Which group of travellers set out from the Tarbin Inn?
It's getting dark now. It's going to get dark later. Canterbury, UK. Hey, Janetti's Corner. Thanks very much for coming in, my friend. Only one more thumbs up to get to 15 now, guys. Horse Riders. Nope. This one's probably quite a hard one. I should have just done this one from the last total quiz question.
There's something in the Canterbury Tales.
Anchor. It is like a hotel. The Jamaican Inn, no? Sheep. I've still got 15 thumbs up now, which is nice. We appreciate everyone giving me a thumbs up.
Do-do-do-dum.
No, not the Tales Inn.
The Canterbury Tales, but what inn?
Zach, that's fine, but don't put that word in the live chat, please. You can really offend somebody. You've not offended me, but you can really offend someone. Don't put that in the live chat, please. Coventry Arena? No. Pirates. Nobody got it yet?
Which group of travellers set out from the Tarbin Inn?
Already in. I know you're apologising, Zach. I just can't have that word in the live chat. And don't use full caps, please, Zach. Holiday Inn, Canterbury Inn.
No, something in the Canterbury Tales, and it is. Which group of travellers set out from the Tarbin Inn?
Yeah, thanks very much for reminding people to like and share, Hilsey. See, we appreciate the love and support. Why are you guys giving me silly answers? Do you guys give up? If you give up, that's fine. We can move on quickly and go to the question not related to it. Irish.
Clancers.
Pilgrims? No. I think everyone gives up.
It was the Pilgrims of the Canterbury Tales.
Am I, what the hell's that?
Apparently that's the answer according to this website. But anyway, we're now going to move on to the question called... Da-da-da-da-dum. The question not related to the quiz. And today's question is... Let me just dig back into the live chat on my tablet, guys. Just forgive me, guys. 1 second. Hope you guys got the fun now for the live stream tonight, too.
Anyway, so, the question not related to the quiz is... And the first two people that get the answer right will get the point.
What train station did I do my live stream at yesterday? And actually,
I've just realised this is kind of geography related. So I've made a bit of a mess up there because this question is kind of geography related because it's you could probably say it's to do with geography. But the question is, what train station did a quiz? Did I do it at least yesterday? And the first two people got it right, which are Lincolnshire Level Crossings and the Train Channel, and got it with Nuneaton. You didn't see that one, did you? Yeah.
It was Nuneaton. I was at yesterday.
So, Lottie and Lincolnshire Level Crossings and the Train Channel. And now we're moving on to Sam Style's questions, because I believe in 40 minutes' time, because I don't think I had a...
I think I do have a raid plan for our work, actually. I'll just forgive me if he set that up yet. Because I haven't had a response bin, but if I don't get him, I'll find somebody else to raid.
The Nuneaton Trent Valley. Faber United, they don't tend to call it Trent Valley. They just call it Nuneaton. Like, Litchfield and Rugia, Litchfield Trent Valley and Rugia Trent Valley, but they just tend to call it Nuneaton. They don't really say Nuneaton Trent Valley. But anyway, maybe I should do a live from one of another West Coast main line station at some point. Because the meeting was fun. I retitled the live stream though. Did you see, guys? Did you see I retitled the live stream? Jobs were for that. When we were talking to that lady that said, can't stand on this platform.
Oh, excuse me. Forgive me for the burping. Anyway, now, moving on, is...
Right. What time zone is the UK currently in? What time zone is the UK currently in? And the first two people that get this right. What time zone as of May 2021 is the UK currently in? Lottie. Lincolnshire Level Crossington's train channel is kind of right, but it's named something. Yeah, 345 Berry got it. Yeah, BST. I'm going to give the point to Lincolnshire Levels and Crossington's train channel because Lottie in the summer is BST. So one more person needs to put BST. So I'm going to give it to 345 Berry, Lincolnshire Level Crossington's train channel, and Faber United UK in the summer months it is BST, but in the winter months it is GMT. So then get your level across onto the train channel, Faber United and 345 Berry. Right, next question is what two European countries border each other, but they do not have the same time zone as each other? What two countries border each other, but do not have the same time zone as each other? No, because Russia's not in Europe. Russia's a separate continent. Oh, Lottie, you're close with Spain. It's Spain and something else. Russia's not considered Europe. Country one and country two. Forgive me, guys, so just address something here on Instagram. France and the Netherlands are in the same time zone. Lincolnshire Level Crossington's Portugal. But you guys now need to tell me what two European countries. Yes, 345 Berry got it. Bang in there with Spain and Portugal. And so Portugal and Spain are both in Europe, but weird this is, but if you walk from one side of the street, from Spain to Portugal, you're in a different time zone because Spain is 1 hour ahead of Portugal for some reason. Don't know why this is, because I'm thinking Spain should be the same time zone as us because it's literally just south of the UK. But Portugal has got the same time zone as the UK, but Spain is 1 hour ahead of Portugal. I don't know why that is, but that's the answer. Weird that, isn't it? Two countries next door to each other. And they're south of the UK. You'd think they're on the same time zone. Nope. Spain's apparently an hour ahead of the UK. And Europe is, and then Portugal's the same time zone as the UK. Now, next question in regards to time zones. It's going to be part 7A of Time Zone Talks with Sam and Corinne. First episode was featured back in February on Corinne's live stream when she was arguing with me over would she be 4 or 5 hours ahead of me. Now, the next question is, how many time zones does the USA cover? How many time zones does the USA cover? Time travels, isn't it? 345 Berry. Yeah, so I've got this appointment in Spain in 1 hour's time. But I thought I'd just time travel. So I've just experienced 3 p.m. here in Spain, but I now want to go back and visit 3 p.m. again. So I'm just going to go 5 minutes down the road to Portugal and it's going to be 3 o'clock again. It's like actually, when you're driving from, let's say, the tip of Paris, or the top of Paris to the tip of England, let's say you leave at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, you can be back at 1:58 p.m. Hey, isn't that cool? Because you go back in time by 2 minutes because of the time zones. Mad that. Link is sure level crossings and train travel. Got it. It is 5 different time zones. Bloody hell.
Because you got Atlantic Standard Time, Eastern Standard Time, Central Time Zone. You got the one on the West Coast. Can't remember what it is. California Standard Time. And then you got Hawaiian time zone. So it is. Who said 5? Lincolnshire level crossings and train time zone. You are correct, my friend. Right.
Next question is. Duck off, think of some more questions now. Hey, Dirt Dickers UK. Thanks very much for coming in. Now, next question is. What is the capital city of Ireland? What is the capital city of Ireland? Rotty got it. It is Dublin.
Dublin is the capital of the Republic of Ireland. Right, next question is
a harder one.
Are you ready for the harder question, guys?
Are you ready for the harder question, guys? So next question is, what is the, let me think of this question now. I knew that internet is gone now.
Right, next question is, I need to think of this question now. We're now have questions to think about. Let me think of a question.
Okay, here's a question for you guys. What is the UK's smallest county? What is the UK's smallest county? And this is a county, by the way, guys. What is the UK's smallest county? And I'm only going to give it to the first person that gets it right. The answer is Rutland. Fabrini 90 got it. It is Rutland. A small little county home to one train station, and who can tell me that train station for a bonus point? Genetics Corner, Fabrini 90 first. Don't forget, guys, if you read the description, it says whoever has it on my side first. And Fabrini 90 is also right with Oakham. So 2 extra points for Fabrini 90. Right, next question is, can you ask a question? Yeah, go ahead, as long as it's appropriate. And then you can think of a geography related quiz. Can you name what is the sky? At the moment, I can read dark blue. Because it's getting dark, so the colour of the sky now is a really dark blue. I want my money back, Sam. What money? He didn't pay to enter the quiz. Anyway, now we're going to have... Bolton Explorers. It's like a really dark blue, light black colour, the sky is, at the moment. Right, next question is, and we're going to have one final hard question. So let me just think of this final hard question. Let me think of something hard to you got for you guys to give. That was you for today's quiz. I've got the answers for. What's my favourite? We did a Q&A, guys, yesterday. Did also of you missed a Q&A we did? Not yesterday. Over the weekend, I'll do another Q&A in June because I'm going to do them every month. But, So the final geography-related question is... How many countries... Hey, Green Facts and Rivers are coming back. We're on the final hardest question, which is... What is the... How many days are in a year? But not any old year. How many days are in a year? And I'm not gonna elaborate it. And that's not a hard question either. 365, correct. But you're not gonna get the point. The reason for it is you guys need to give me a specific answer. Lynching Shore Level Crossings and Change Channels is closed. And I'm going to give it actually to Faithful United, who says, any specific year? I just thought I'd do a silly random one for the end, which is, which is a leap year is 366, and then a normal year is 365. So very well done to you. So that is the final question of the quiz. So yeah. A shorter one tonight, I suppose. We've been on live for just over an hour. So 365 days in 1 year, but every leap year, which happens every 4 years, and the next leap year will be in 2024, is 366 days. Because actually, it takes the Earth 365.4 days, I think it is, to spin around. So what they do is, because of that, every 4 years they have a leap year where they give you an extra day. And that happens every 4 years, and so happens to be also the year when the Olympics is held. But not this year, because of the pandemic we had, the Olympics weren't held last year. So I believe the Olympics, I'm not sure, are the Olympics taking place in this summer? Bolton Explorers, don't go anywhere. We're not finished yet. We now need to reveal the results and see about a quiz for next week. But if you're heading off, that's fine. So good night, Bolton Explorers. But we've still got a bit of finishing off to do before we head off tonight. And I'm thinking, I'm sure Alex said he wanted to raid me, but I don't see the premiere that he's going to be raided for. So we'll have to think, see if anybody else has got something coming up. I don't see a premiere. So, hey, thanks so much for coming in, Classy Cooker. You've just missed out on the quiz, but we're going to reveal the results. Britain's Got Talent style, and then we're going to think about a quiz for next week. February 90, make sure you limit your emojis to 2 or 3 because YouTube can say that loads of emojis can be considered spam. But anyway, so now we're going to reveal the results. And obviously, I need to make sure everybody's in the live chat who's been participating tonight. So, to make it fair, so everybody knows that I'll be revealing the results. So, and hit thumbs up as well, guys. We've only got 17 thumbs up, and I want to get to 20. So, hit thumbs up as well, guys, and shout out the stream. You guys know what to do by now. You guys know what to do.
Right, you guys know what to do. So, Fable United is still in the live chat. Jamie left, didn't he? Zach, are you still in the live chat? Zach Trains, are you still in here? 345 Belly, still in the house? No, I'm not doing a teacher's impression, 345 Belly. I couldn't even probably do one of them. Lincolnshire Level Crossings and Train Channel, still in the house. Lottie's Explores UK is still in the other house. Thank you very much for the kind words. It was a great quiz indeed. Great geography quiz. Fable United, you are actually allowed visitors if they're in your support bubble. But you can meet people in the garden. But here in England, from Monday the 17th of May, we can meet 6 people or 2 households inside. Or 30, a large gathering outside. You just sort it out. Okay, that's going to be in 23 minutes. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to be on for a little bit longer whilst we sort out the results and decide for a quiz about next week. So, Zach, are you still in here? And I know Pete's lurking in the background because he just said hello to Classy Cookery, so... Let me put you a message. Hey, Retalk Reaction Steve, welcome back. Or break the rules and you see anyone you want whenever you want. What? Oh yeah, that one as well, Retalk Reaction Steve. Only a heavy arm class of eight after my second, I had one Saturday. Make sure you don't talk about stuff like that in the live chat, please, 345 Belly. Just because I don't want YouTube to flag me. My husband... No of that talk in the live chat, please, guys. But anyway, guys. Anyway, we're going to reveal the results. I'm not sure if Zach's in here, so we're just going to move on quickly, guys. So, in no particular order, I'll announce who's in the top three. So, let me just wipe this out. And we've got a joint third place winner again this week. We had the same thing last time. Red Hot Reactions, make sure you just limit your emojis to 2 or 3 because YouTube can consider that spam. What happened? I can't have any of the C-Virus talk in the live stream because YouTube can flag you for that. No worries at all, Classy Cookeries. But anyway, we're going to reveal the results, so in no particular order, so... Zach, you're not in here because you buggered off some ago. But Zach, unfortunately, you are not in the top three. Da-da-da-da-dum. Right, now... Fable United, you... Oh, in the top three. Jamie, you are in the top three. 345 Belly, you are in the top three. And Lottie's Explores UK, you are also in the top three. Now, unfortunately, that means Pete, you are unfortunately just missed out on a place in the top three today. I do apologise for that, so unfortunately, Pete... You've just missed out on a place. And we do have a joint third place winner today. So. I'm not sure about that one, to be honest with you, Red Hot Reactions. Because I don't use TikTok, you see. Forgive me. I'm sorry about that. I just can't have any of the C-Virus talk in the live chat. So I'm not 100% sure on that one, Red Hot Reactions. You have to forgive me for that, because I'm not on TikTok, you see.
Well, I have an account with 250 followers. My grandson starts an account on Sunday and has... Oh, my God. You rarely post on TikTok, do you, Fable United? Make sure you hit thumbs up, guys. Only two more thumbs up, get to 20. Not everyone is. There was a few people that weren't in the top three. But so Pete and Zach just missed out on a place. But we do have a joint third place. People. And we'll announce those people. Maybe it's because your granddad's not... Maybe because your grandson's doing something funny on there with your reactions. Lol. Anyway, so the third place people are then are... 345 Bay with 6 points, Lottie's Explorers UK with 6 points, and Lincolnshire Level Crossings and Strange Channels all had 6 points, which means for tonight only, and this has never happened on any of my quizzes before, they are our joint third place participants. That's good. It must have hit up a bit then if he had 1,000 followers for adult reaction. I can't believe that happened though. You've only got 250 followers. You post quite a lot then because, he must have posted something half decent if he's got over 1,000 followers, man. So that means, but we need now, we're only left with two people. These people are Jamie, Newtown Abbey is 208, who's not in the live chat now, he's gone to bed. And we're left with Fabian United. So, drum roll please. We can confirm the winner is. Drum roll please. And he's won twice. Fabian United, so a big congratulations to Fabian United. You've already had on the show, you've already had a shout out for the quiz. So obviously no winners tonight. So well, Fabian United did win, but obviously no shout outs for tonight because he's already had one. So obviously he played for fun. Because obviously I do use shout outs for people that haven't had one before. So well done, Fabian United. Lottie Sports UK, there's no prize for third place peeps, unfortunately. The only the winner usually gets a shout out, and that's the person that's gone first place. But if they've already had shout outs and stuff before in the past 6 months or so, obviously, no shout out. They just play for fun. I've got quite a lot like other people do here, to be honest with you, 345 Lottie Sports UK. But anyway, Classy Cookery, how do your lunch, guys? Lunch, yeah, Classy Cookery. Forgive me, what time is it for you then? Because it's just coming up to, it's bang on 9:45, is, third prize is Wopsits. I'm not going to lie to you, I had a bag of Wopsits for breakfast today because I woke up late and I had them left over from my lunch yesterday. So don't tell anybody else, guys. I had a pack of Wopsits for breakfast because I'm so unhealthy. Oh, it's 9:45 for you. So, yeah, forgive me because I've already had lunch. And I know I had dinner about a few hours ago. And for dinner, I had chicken thighs with salad. And then for lunch, I had a sausage roll. So, yeah. So, it's a classy cookery. So, you're like 8.
No.
Yeah, you're 8 hours behind me, so you're living in California standard time. That's cool. I just had sausage and chips, classy. Sausage and chips. It would have been, if you had fish and chips, Steve, read up the reactions, it would be more British. But yeah, very classy there. Sausage and chips.
Yeah, it's 6:15 for you. Forgive, so Corrine, have you had, you said you're cooking. What did you cook tonight, Corrine? I had chicken thighs with some nice juicy salad. And Corrine, I was when I was watching that vlog yesterday. Jeez, why is meat? Yeah, Pacific Standard Time. That's right, Corrine. Why is meat so expensive in Canada? Why is Canada so expensive? You had barbecue chicken. That sounds really nice. I hope you saved me one. But can you answer my question, Corrine? Why is meat and everything so expensive in Canada? I don't get it. In the UK, it's expensive but cheap at the same time. Few places are cheap, a few are expensive. We have kind of like our supermarkets tend to go up in price, like Waitrose is like they're expensive, and M&S, Sainsbury's, Tesco, Asda, all the way down to the bottom of Lidl and Aldi.
you don't have a clue. Yeah, meat. I was watching it wrong. And I was like, $10 for one pack of chicken. I was asking you. No, I was saying Kareem, but what are you having for dinner, actually, Classy Cookie, whilst we're on that subject? I was saying, yeah, Kareem, but I was thinking your chicken's very expensive because chicken is, if I went up to my local Asda now, which is a store, obviously, here in England, it's, I think I can get a pack of chicken for £4, which is probably, like, Alexa, volume down to 3. Alexa, what's £4 in Canadian dollars?
£4 is about $6.84.
So yeah, for just under $7, we can get chicken here in England. Why is your meat so expensive, Kareem? No, it's not, Alec. I've just asked her, and chicken in my local Asda is like £4 for a packet, and that's like just under six, that's like just over $6 in Canadian dollars. Like, she's paying like almost $4 more for chicken compared to the UK prices. I think you need to move to the UK, Kareem, cheaper, yeah? How much is it for milk in the States? Just the standard item you'd buy. Yeah, but Kareem, even then, I think our most expensive chicken, if you want like a whole big chicken, I think you pay like £10. £10-15, which is like $20, so you can understand for a big chicken, but for like just some standard breasts or thighs, like I had chicken thighs.